dear fellow sim racers. My name is Michael, and today I've decided I'm gonna do a refresh of the videos I've made. I think it was 2017, actually, maybe 18, and we are speaking about dual reel timing. I wouldn't say a lot has changed, but some things are different, and some of those things I said and showed you in the previous videos are not up to date anymore. So let's take a look at how do you install, how do you run it, and just the basics overall. First of all, we need to download JRT itself. So let's start with basics. Joel-real-timing.com is the website you are looking for, basically. Over here, I will hover over to English language, as I do not speak, neither I understand French. And besides that, you can find a lot of useful information on the website. I don't really think that much people are using those. And I think that the video is not always, but for me at least, when I'm on your side, when I'm trying to understand something, I prefer videos, basically. So where do you start? First of all, you have two ways: paid version and free version. Free version has a bit limited functionalities, but if you want to use it as, you know, not everyday iRacing driver, but just from time to time, but you prefer, for example, you're used to the from Assetto Corsa, Assetto Corsa Competizione, Automobilista, and so on, and you want to use some kind of dash or lifetiming, you can do that. So basically what you get here is you can buy the JRT license, which is for 25 euros. This will last you for 1 year. After that, and I think it is right here, expressed quite clearly, after that, when your license expires, you're only left with updates until a certain point, which you will be able to find. That means that if I would buy a license right now for 1 year, and I would come back to the racing in 2 years, it's not like I will have the free version. I will still have the premium or pro version, but we just update until certain time. That means I might miss some features. If you are like me and you're using JRT for years, you can buy a JRT update extension, which basically means that you will get all of those nice and juicy up-to-date features. Apart from that, both ways you get a pro license. So let's get started. Actually, let's click download, and here you can see a list of all of different versions. And here in orange color or brown, you can see that if your JRT update license expires on 1st of December 2021 or later, you can get these updates. But if I scroll back in the past, let's say, here it says that you can only use basically this client because you will just not get the features anyway. So if your license would expire 2020 the 1st of September, you can only download this version. It will let you to download a newer version, but you will not have the features regardless. So I would advise you, or I recommend you, to only download what your license is good for. If you see that there is tons of new features you would enjoy, just buy for 10 euros the extension, and you'll be good to go. Well, you might ask why there is so many versions: with CUDA, without CUDA, update without CUDA. Well, basically CUDA are the cores in your GPU if you're using NVIDIA GPU, and they are designed to do certain tasks, basically. And Joel takes advantage of those tasks, not for regular JRT purposes like dashboard, lifetiming, track map, but for photo mode. I will not go into the details. So basically, you can use the version with CUDA. You will just not use the feature it gives you, but you can also, like me, use without CUDA cores or without CUDA. If you are already owner of older JRT, you can only get the update. So you get, you basically get four different options, and basically two based on if you're using CUDA or not. So at this point, I would get the setup without CUDA. You just click on it, you download it. It is around 140 megabytes. I will not be going through the installation process because it's pretty much straightforward. And we will skip right into the point where you get things, let's say, running. So during the installation process, you could choose if you want to save a shortcut to your desktop. However, I will start where you find things because you will not be using it just once, basically. Over here, you can see I've got the folder, Joel Real Timing No CUDA. If you install with CUDA, it will be called just Joel Real Timing. I keep it installed for the default where it asks for, which is directly on the C drive. And you go to the No CUDA file. You can see there's a lot of folders, a lot of files, the HTMLs, different DLLs, stuff like that. Basically, what you need every single time you work with Joel Real Timing is following Joel Real Timing Server No CUDA. This is the exe file, and this is what we need to read data from the game so it is, let's say, transferred somewhere else where you can display it based on different rules. So let's run the JRT Server No CUDA. You can see it has been started here on the tray because I already got a what would you call it, the shortcut, let's say, on the quick access menu. And you can see this is some sort of command with lots and lots of data. So this has been everything for today's video. We have seen where do you get the JRT. We've seen how the premium system works, like how the updates work, and what's the difference between CUDA version and no CUDA version. In the future videos, we will go through the basics. How do you actually display things? On what devices you can actually display it? And how you do a brief and simple edit to the pages. Stay tuned, Michael out.